Hello, I'm a generator lecturer in metallurgy. I'm a scientist and I never been to the university to study theology. So I'm a new skin capable of taking the new wine which was produced by Christ Jesus. And it is obtained through logical reasoning. People who go to the universities, they learn dead letters, incapable of logical reasoning. Dead letters give the old wine and they are happy with it. Debating and all discussing, you know, when you ask them simple question, in whose name? John the Baptist baptized a Jewish man in water. Why he did not baptize a woman, a Gentile or a Samaritan? They are at a loss. I know it, they don't know it. I call them super donkeys carrying holy books. So these university professors with dog collar, they are super donkeys. And they are the super blind guides of the super blind who in the churches say, our Father in heaven. And that Father in heaven was Yahweh. And he is no more alienated. Our Father is in here. Our Father is Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm. He does not live in the brick-built temple. He lives in the living temple because he is a living God, not a dead one, like the demiurge Yahweh, potter of this one. So, here I am rendering exposition of Matthew 9, verse 1 to 8. Holy Gospel of our Supernatural Father, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc. Delivered by the First Anointed Christ, which in Punjabi, my native language, we call Satguru Jesus, of the highest living God, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, that dwells within his temple of God, not made by human hand, but by the Lord of the nature, created by the demiurge potter, the Lord of the nature, Yahweh, Brahma, Khudah, same thing. And it is called Harmandir. Har mean God, Mandir mean his temple, or Emmanuel, because God lives in his temple, not outside. According to Saint Matthew 9, 1 to 8. So if the God lives inside, he is no more in heaven. You don't say prayer to God. He doesn't listen prayer. He can't understand it. He understands his word and his language. When you preach gospel, then he understands you. And not when you say prayer, fasting and other thing. So you can see super blind people are in the society and they are causing sectarian riots, as in India in 1947 and in Ireland, Catholic and Protestant killing each other and all that, you know. Pope is Antichrist. Nobody can give your account. So you have to give your own account to God. So after entering a boat, Jesus made the crossing and came into his own town. And there, people brought to him a paralytic lying on a stretcher. When Jesus saw their faith, because those who bring it to him, they had the faith in Jesus that he can cure. When Jesus saw their faith, he said to the paralytic, courage, child, your sins are forgiven. Because this body is, you get this body through karma, or we call works. In Punjabi we say the second coming of Jesus was Nanak, and he has told us karmi ave kapda nadri moh dwar, that through your past deeds, karma in your past life, give you this birth of human birth. By the grace of our Supernatural Father, you get salvation. So salvation you get when you become his son. His son you become when you preach gospel from heart, gospel cannot be written down in ink on paper. So Bible is forbidden in the royal kingdom of God. So here is our situation with Jesus. Oh dear. Here is John the Baptist holding scripture. Law and prophets were till John the Baptist, Luke 16, verse 16. After that one, this kingdom is opened by Christ Jesus. So he fades away and he rises. The dark ages of Christ and no more in this Rabbis. So John the Baptist, he was prophet Elijah. Elijah means my God is Yahweh. So he worked for Yahweh. And our Christ Jesus worked for Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, our supernatural father, who is the Lord of the Sabbath. I will come to that one. So here is John the Baptist. He baptized Jewish men in water in the name of Abraham, because when they become Jew outwardly in the temple, they were making them by circumcising Gentile and other people. Circumcision is the tribal mark of Abraham to Isaac. Only the people of Isaac can be circumcised, nobody else. So they were making fake sons of Abraham, and so making them Gentile by circumcising, telling them, now you are a Jew, as they are Mohammedan. By circumcision they make you, now you are a Muslim. So they are all fake. So those people realize that when they become Jew outwardly, they can't build their covenant to Abraham. Because if Abraham was a Jew outwardly, then Ishmael people would be Jew as well, but they are not. So Jew is a spiritual self, not the physical self. So he baptized them in the name of their tribal father, which was Abraham. And he never, because they were the only people who became Jew outwardly. The Gentile, they were sons of their tribal father. They did not need baptism. So a woman doesn't have carry any tribe, because when she gets married, her surname changes. Woman is the counterpart of God for supplying blood. And man is the counterpart of Adam for supplying water, semen. So the Jewish people who realize that when they become Jew outwardly, they break their covenant with Abraham, they left the temple and they came to John the Baptist. He was the cornerstone of the temple. He was ousted out by the hypocrite people of Judah tribe. They were dominating temple. Remember, in Judah tribe people, they killed Zechariah, prophet Zechariah. They ousted out John the Baptist, and they, Elisha, they were so bad, their conscience, they were so greedy, and their hearts were so dirty. Elisha did not think there was any person worthy to be cleansed of leprosy. But Naaman, of clean heart, came from Syria. He happily cured him and did not accept any present, because in God there is no money counted. Money has no value here. Money has value here. But Elisha, he was prophet Elisha from this here, from the royal kingdom. So when he bring the present and he was taking them back, then two greedy people followed him. And one excuse or the other, they took present off from him. And that greed gave them leprosy. The temple priest, by making them Jew outwardly, in the next birth they become vipers. So that's why John the Baptist told them, "You brood of vipers. Don't you think you are sons of Abraham? I can turn stones into sons of Abraham." Stone means simple-minded people. So here, John the Baptist baptized Jewish men in water in the name of Abraham. Never baptize a woman because she doesn't have a tribe or identity. So never baptize a woman, a Gentile, because they were not unfaithful to their tribal father. And never a Samaritan. Samaritan, they were faithful to Abraham, faithful to Yahweh. They were a prophet of, they were a nation of prophets who possessed 5 talents. They turned 5 talents into 10 by preaching gospel. So much more I can tell. However, let's carry on. So these people of spirit, Holy Spirit, which is common sense, they came to John the Baptist when baptized, then to become the son of the Most High, where your soul is concerned, not the flesh. Because soul in everyone, even in a dog, elephant, is the same soul which is in a human being. So here our soul counts, because our supernatural father is the father of our souls, not flesh. So they were seeking to enter this narrow gate. Sadhus, when you ask them their tribal identity, they will tell you that we became sadhu, we don't carry any tribal identity. But if you ask them in which tribal home you were born, then they will tell you. But otherwise they don't tell you their tribal identity. So here the some became eunuchs for the royal kingdom of God. So here then they bury the ego, bury the ego of the tribal ego and turn it into plant, where the tribal identity become implicit and spiritual explicit. Here your tribal identity is explicit under John the Baptist. This is below and this is above. Above of sadhus, where your spiritual identity counts. So all here are brethren, whether in flesh you are a male or a female, doesn't matter, because the soul in you is the son of the Most High Elohim. Soul counts, not your physical body. So here we are all brethren, and here these twice-born people, they could be fished into the royal kingdom of God. So here we are the fishers of men who are twice-born, who have buried the ego of their tribal ego and turned it into living plant. Plant will bear fruit, not the seed. So this is the celestial word of sadhus, Melchizedek. And here we have one father, and we are all his children. That's why Jesus said, don't call anybody a father in this world. But we have one father, God, which is Elohim. So, excuse me. So this is John the Baptist, a rabbi. And here is Christ Jesus. I will give you the relationship between the two in this graph. a picture. So here is a John the Baptist moon, and primary source of light, sun, is Christ Jesus. So John the Baptist was a witness to this light, but not the light. But light was Christ Jesus. Here we are saint, sons of the Most High. Here you are prophets. Prophets are those who are perfect in the moral law, who are the weapon master of the rabbis. That's why John the Baptist was a prophet. He was not a saint. And people in the churches, you know, they make churches Saint John the Baptist. And there's one church in Essex which is associated with Mount Athos, which is associated with Mount Athos. And priest over there come. I went there two times and told them that this John the Baptist, he wasn't a saint, he was an angel. And they don't mind me. And they took my remarks, whatever I told them, aggressive, that this man is a Gnostic and he is a heretic. So I left them, you know. So you don't throw pearls before swine. So over there in Mount Athos, the abbots, they are controlling them. Abbots, in Jesus, we are set free, solitary. Over there, they are controlling them. They are under law, and they are antichrist. So that's what you get from them, darkness. So here is John the Baptist, and here the sin. So this is the regime of the sin, John the Baptist. Law and prophets were till John the Baptist. No law, no sin. So in Christ Jesus is our heart is concerned. Going against the heart is called blasphemy. Here blasphemy counts. And blasphemy is unforgivable. Nobody can forgive blasphemy, because blasphemy is against Holy Spirit. And Holy Spirit is of our supernatural Father. So blasphemers, they get punished. And the greatest blasphemers you have are the Tony Blair and Bush, who told the people that sadomasochism had weapons of mass destruction, but none were found by a major general who went there. So they told pack of lies from the core of their heart. And look, they are free. A man who exposed the blasphemer, Assange, he is in. So we should support our brother Assange and get the blasphemer in the International Court of Justice for killing so many people. So let's see what else we need. A little cold, you know. Okay, let's carry on. So, sins of transgression against the moral laws created by the temple priests. And so they have the authority to forgive them after the victim has paid a sum to them. The victim pays a sum to them for getting their cured, you know, of their sins. That's why Jesus, after curing a leper, he will tell them, go to your priest and pay him according to the law of Moses. So it was a business, as the law courts make today. Law courts, you know, they are the same, making a business out of the people. Jesus knew what they were thinking and said, why do you harbor evil thoughts? In Jesus, you know, God has no evil thoughts in his mind. So if you have the mind of our supernatural Father, you always think good of everyone. If good is happening, you are happy. If somebody is doing wrong thing, then we are not happy. Then we show our wrath, you know. In Jesus, our base is agape. Agape is unconditional divine love. And there is no element of hatred or the evil thoughts, or of the evil thoughts. Which is easier to say, your sins are forgiven, or to say, rise and walk? As Jesus was the Lord of the Sabbath, or of nature at large. Nature at large, you know, what you see with two naked eye, nature, and the one that make the nature living is of our supernatural Father, soul come from there. So this body, nature, is useless without soul. So then here it is, the relationship in menorah. So these parts, three here, social, ecumenical, political affair, David's cross, evil and holy. Some are holy, some are evil. One on the left of the middle candle, they are evil. On the right, they are holy. So these parts are created by Yahweh, the demiurge creator of nature, Lord of the nature. The soul in us is not natural, it's supernatural. It comes from the middle candle. So from middle candle, these candles are lit. So this middle candle is of Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, our supernatural Father. So without this soul, they are dead. So this light, or the soul, life in these soul, is the Lord of these bodies, or Lord of the creation of Yahweh. Yahweh is the Lord of the creation, and Elohim is the Lord of the creation. That without soul, they are all dead. For the living world, Elohim is the Lord of the living world, not of the dead. That's why Jesus said, our Father is the, he is the Father of the living, and not of the spiritually dead people, which the Rabbis were producing, men of dead letters, deaf and dumb. So Jesus had to put finger in their ears and all that, you know, to open their ears, to make them free from the clutches of the their rabbis, as Saul was made free from the clutches of Gamaliel. And when his eyes were opened, thick scale came, that was the representing the darkness the rabbi had created in the disciples. So here you are. So this is, that's why Jesus said he is the Lord of the Sabbath. This is the kingdom of heaven and hell seen outside. This is the royal kingdom of God which is within your heart. Opposite. Our Christianity is of heart and not of the dead book. That's why the covenant of the letters finishes with John the Baptist. So here you are. Here the our covenant was of letters, law and prophets here finishes. So Bible is letters. So here our covenant is of Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit is common sense. So You can't take Bible here. Bible is forbidden, so is money forbidden. That's why those people who joined the royal kingdom of God, Matthew sold half of his possessions, because half belonged to him, half to his wife, to join hands with Jesus. Peter left his family and everything to join Christ Jesus. So the first church, when it was formed, people sold their possession to enter this field. Well, onions and sphera, they sold their possession, but they kept back money and they told lie to Peter, blasphemy. So the blasphemer were killed before they entered this narrow gate. So Peter is the gatekeeper. He is feeding the sheep, good quality sheep, no love of mammon. So these doctoral priests in the churches, they are Judas Iscariot in sheep's clothing. Judas Iscariot was thrown out at the Last Supper because he was the thief, not capable or suitable for entering into the royal kingdom of God. He can't enter here with money in his pocket or anything. So he was thrown out because he was a thief. So are these doctoral priests. They can't enter this one because they are thief, working for mammon, stealing money from the church purse. So in Jesus we form fellowship, and not these churches which you have here. They are synagogue of Satan. And that's why they create sectarian riots and all that trouble in the world. So it's very easy, and all come from here. You must be living in Holy Spirit. You must be capable of thinking logically. Otherwise, you can't have gospel. So gospel is by the grace of our supernatural Father, and you can't make it equal to anyone. Jesus knew what they were thinking and said, why do you harbor evil thoughts? In Jesus, our base is agape, unconditional divine love. And there's no element of hatred or evil thoughts. Which is easier to say, your sins are forgiven, or to say, rise and walk? Jesus was the Lord of the Sabbath, or of nature at large, that the rabbis controlled. So I explained to him, with soul come from our supernatural Father. Without soul, this is dead. As Jesus was the Lord of the Sabbath, or of nature at large, that the rabbis control, but that you may know that the Son of Man, the second Adam, Yahshua. Now the word Yahshua is made of two words, Yah from Yahweh, and Shua or Shiva being the primal Adam. So Jesus was the, I show you. So this is the primal Adam. Then under it we are races and all that. So Jesus was Shua or Shiva, primal Adam. So he was the second Adam. And Mary was surrogate mother, Joseph foster father. So Mary was sired by Yahweh, not by any tribal, not by any person of the first Adam. So that's the word Yeshua stands that his birth was virgin, sired by Yahweh. That's why John the Baptist, who was working for Yahweh, he said, I'm working for Yahweh and his creation under Adam, and you yourself are Adam. I can't touch your feet. But Jesus said, fulfill, so that the people can understand that you must be born of water first, and then you will be born of God. If you don't have the spirit or the common sense to know your tribal father, you cannot know your spiritual father. This is outwardly and this is inwardly. A Jew is one who is inwardly, not outwardly. So you can see all Hindu, Sikh, Muslim, Jew come under here. Never born, never die. So not a single Jew died during the Holocaust. But people of Judah tribe, Benjamin tribe, led by their blind guide, they died in the Holocaust. Same in 1947 in India. People led by their blind guide, they died. My father had this knowledge. So 2,000 people came to attack our village. And my father told them that we tribal people going to kill each other. And the headman understood it. So he told the 2,000 people to look after us as their guest, which they did. So this planet Earth is for the habitation for the sons of man. All the sons of Satan will disappear, killing each other. They are the tares. So I lived in Ghana. Over there are so many tribes. And over there, people live like brethren. There's no hatred against any of them. If you give them something to share, give one, he will share with everyone, equal. With no selfishness. That is the, in Adam, sons of man do. Son of man, the second Adam, Yahshua, has authority on earth to forgive sins. He then said to the paralytic, rise, pick up your stretcher and go home. He rose and went home. When the crowd saw this, they were struck with awe and glorified God, Elohim, who had given such authority to human beings. So they appreciated the common man, but not those rabbis, Farsi, Sadducee. Same way I go to the Oxford University to tell them what I have learned from Christ Jesus. And when I tell them that Jesus, John the Baptist, he never baptized a woman, a Gentile or a Samaritan, but only the Jewish men. Then I ask them in whose name he did it. They have no idea. So you can see John the Baptist said, I'm baptizing in water. The one coming after me will baptize in Holy Spirit. It's written there. They are super blind. So don't you think they are knowledgeable people with all their degrees and dog collars? They are super blind. And no wonder they throw me out of their seminars and other things. Because I ask them awkward questions. That's why they call us heretic. Gnostics are heretic. Because they can't answer the question. Much more you can ask, learn by yourself if you are twice born. So, in Jesus, you remember that Moses created arrows in the wilderness. And that rift between two brethren who were fighting in Egypt. And Moses told, hey, your brethren, don't fight. But in the wilderness, when they were made sons of, faithful sons of Abraham, then they became brethren. And there were no more rift. And that is the snake lifted up. So in arrows, which is flesh, which is love of flesh, tribal love. Moses lifted up the snake, tribal rift between the people. And what about our supernatural father? In Agape, Christ bring in Agape. Agape lift the international rift, or the cobras on international basis. If we are living in Holy Spirit and promote it and not let these hireling Dokoru priest to create sectarian roles to fulfill Matthew 12 verse 43 to 45, making the situation worse than before the arrival of Jesus. Much more in my other videos. And our Father God blesses everyone in Agape, unconditional divine love.